At a valuation of $100 billion, SpaceX now competes heavily with the fintech company Stripe for the title of the world's second most valuable private company. Sitting firmly behind ByteDance, the company behind TikTok, SpaceX is nearly unrivaled in terms of other multi-billion dollar private companies. Oddly enough, the company makes just a fraction of what ByteDance, the most valuable private company, does. For reference, ByteDance's 2020 revenue came in at a whopping $37 billion, on par with Nike, the sportswear giant. As for SpaceX, estimates put their 2018 revenue at around $2 billion. While that's likely nowhere near where it stands now, there's the reasoning behind not believing that the company has increased revenue by nearly 20 times in just 3 years. That'd be a whopping 164 compound growth for the last 3 years. Even compared to Stripe, the payment processing giant worth around $100 billion, SpaceX's revenue is likely below the $7 billion reported by Stripe. So why is SpaceX currently worth $100 billion? Well, there are a few reasons inside that answer. So let's start with the most obvious. Launches. In 2020, SpaceX launched 26 missions, 5 more than 2018's 21. According to Forbes, who put the estimated average revenue per launch at roughly $80 million, we'd be looking at approximately $1 billion in revenue. Of course, that's making some assumptions, including how much SpaceX charges for Falcon 9 launches, although that's the only thing we can go from. As SpaceX is a private company, there are no easily findable pieces on their revenue, customer base, or profits. At $1 billion in revenue, there are no reasonable ways that SpaceX could be valued at a whopping $100 billion. Of course, though, that's not all of their revenue. It's not even all of their launches. If you noticed, $1 billion in revenue from $80 million launches would be just 12 or 13 Falcon 9 launches. And well, that's because those were the launches that SpaceX was paid for. The other 13 or 14, depending on who you ask, were Starlink launches. Compared to the contract launches, Starlink launches were primarily SpaceX owned and operated, focused on pushing 60 satellites at a time. And therefore, that's where a considerable portion of SpaceX's value comes from. According to SpaceX founder and CEO Elon Musk, over 100,000 users have subscribed to Starlink, with a whopping 500,000 orders. That was for early August and May. For 100,000 users, that's already $120 million in constantly renewing monthly revenue of around $99. As for the 500,000 orders, that's $250 million. So in total, the 500,000 orders of $499 satellites will push out more than twice the revenue that the recurring 100,000 subscribers will in an entire year. Weirdly enough, that's still just under $400 million in revenue from Starlink. Some estimates have put Starlink's investment in the project at a whopping $5 to $10 billion already. That's over 10 times the revenue that they're currently on track to make this year. And don't start with profits. We don't know the operational costs or how much Starlink needs per satellite to start making money back on their initial investment. Still, you don't get valued off what you've done when you're messing with potentially high growth markets. Instead, a company's valued on what it might become. And well, there's a lot that SpaceX might become, which includes Starlink. That all starts with this month's final initial Starlink release. Just October 7th, Musk announced that there should be a nationwide United States rollout by the end of October. That's fantastic news, especially considering how much Starlink has been held back by its beta form. Of course, that beta form was still enough to attract hundreds of millions in revenue within just a few months, but a full release will let SpaceX push priority toward the growing satellite internet service. Speaking of satellite services, the global satellite communication market is valued at a whopping $67 billion by itself, growing compounded at 10% for the next few years. And while that includes tracking, drones connectivity, data backup, navigation, broadcasting, and then the internet and beyond, Starlink is already positioning itself to rise to the top for quite a few of those. While there hasn't been anything officially yet, we've already discussed how satellites like Starlink could push past just satellite internet and break into countless new markets. Also, there's just the sheer size of the current satellite internet market to gain from. In 2020, the global satellite internet market, specifically, was worth around $3 billion. By 2030, it's projected to be worth nearly $20 billion. This year, the US market for satellite TV was valued at $38 billion alone. A few years from now, those two markets, satellite internet and TV, could be valued at more than $50 billion. And Starlink is set to tap into both of them. Satellite internet is obvious. SpaceX will likely take a large percentage of the potential market while also expanding it with its easy-to-set-up dishes. As for satellite TV, with cable TV slowly moving digital to streaming, Starlink's set to benefit from that. While bills keep growing for cable TV, the need to swap to a streaming is too. The issue is, with today's satellites, they're just one-third as fast as the US's average broadband speeds, and that'll mess up some chances for many planning to cut the cable, as well as do virtually anything else demanding on the internet. SpaceX and Starlink can access that growing demand for the internet. Faster download speeds, lower prices, greater availability, and whatever else to become a mammoth throughout not just the global satellite market, but the global internet services market. That's precisely why SpaceX is valued the way it is. With the exponential growth of Starlink and the exponentially growing need for something like it to replace not only the past slow satellite internet, but also to future-proof many rural communities, the possibilities are endless. Even at 10% of that tiny satellite internet TV market listed, that's still a whopping $5 billion in annual revenue split up into friendly little recurring monthly payments. That'd mean if Starlink was the entirety of the company, it'd be worth a 20 price-to-sales ratio right now. That's not too bad, considering some smaller companies with smaller revenues and lower growth rates are valued at 30 times or higher. And so, what do you think? Should SpaceX be valued at $100 billion? Or is that a lot for a company still so early in what it plans to do? Wait a minute. What is that? Is that Starship? No, wait. Of course. SpaceX also happens to be humanity's greatest chance, at the moment, to make it to the Moon and Mars. And the method, Starship, is another huge aspect of SpaceX's valuation. We're already looking at potentially multi-billion dollar contracts from NASA for the Artemis program, the world's return to the moon after quite a while. Consistent trips to the ISS, plans to create suborbital flights, and a rocket that does work. Sure, it's not quite to Mars-level launches yet, but it still flies. SpaceX is already pointing towards FAA approval for the orbital flight, and if done successfully, Starship could be a massive moneymaker. Ignoring the obvious brand new economy on a whole other planet, the sheer availability of a cheaper, reusable rocket would prove an enormous boost to SpaceX's revenue. Plus, we'd be ignoring the money that SpaceX would make from ticket sales aboard a Starship. Flights like Inspiration 4, the contracts from continuous trips to the Moon or Mars, and much more. And that's precisely why SpaceX is worth so much. It's not just because they'll make a few billion from launches to orbit, own a satellite internet service, or have plans for a reusable rocket to fly to other planets. It's because they're so unpredictable and are ready to do so much more than what's expected. We've already seen ideas for potential uses of Starship as a commercial space debris cleaner, defense against asteroids, a massive telescope, a mining station, an interplanetary cargo vehicle, a deep space satellite, the list goes on. The same applies to Starlink. Of course, there's the potential for billions in internet subscriptions, but there's also the potential for space tracking contracts, use in navigation, a commercialized substitute for GPS, and all the other innovative things that could pop up at one point or another. That randomness and continued innovation, combined with rapid growth and a surprisingly heavy focus on quality over quantity, is why SpaceX is currently valued at $100 billion and is ready to keep on climbing. Compared to some of Musk's other endeavors, which have been more outstanding successes to some over others, SpaceX is really prepared to take off. Literally. And that's actually where this one ends. What do you think? With SpaceX passing the $100 billion mark, will the company's value continue to climb, or will it crash and burn? As flights continue to speed up, Starlink continues to exponentially grow, Starship approaches commercialization, and the dream of going back to the Moon, then Mars, continues to grow, what happens next? Let us know your thoughts in the comments and check out some of our other videos for more content on SpaceX or even space in general. Until then, see you next time.